Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for October to December 2020. Rainfall to the end of 2020 is likely to be above average over the eastern two-thirds of the country. But first, we'll look at recent conditions. Recent rainfall should support winter crop yields and boost soil moisture in parts of southeastern Australia. In the tropics, showers brought 77 millimetres to Darwin over 3 days, resulting in an earlier than normal northern rainfall onset. September days were very warm across northern Australia, with temperatures reaching over 40 degrees in some areas and some early season records. Hot, dry conditions also led to catastrophic fire danger levels in Western Australia and the Northern Territory. While recent rain has improved soil moisture across many areas, it's still below average in WA and parts of Southeast Australia. Water storages across the Murray-Darling Basin and New South Wales coast are in a much better position than this time last year. However, it's been a poor winter filling season so far for WA, Victoria and Tasmania. What will influence our climate in the coming months? In the Pacific Ocean, we see the classic La Niña signature of cooler than normal water in the central and eastern Pacific, and warmer than usual water to the north of Australia. For the Indian Ocean, we're likely to see negative Indian Ocean dipole values in October and November. Both La Niña and negative IOD events typically increase the chance of above average rainfall across much of Australia during spring and early summer. This is reflected in our October to December rainfall outlook. The eastern two-thirds of Australia is likely to be wetter than average, with the strongest signal across large parts of the southeast. Even with good rainfalls, water will first need to soak into relatively dry soils before we see increases in stream flows. The forecast for September to November suggests near median to low stream flows are likely at 80% of locations. The forecast high flows are mainly expected in the southeast. For these wetter catchments and with above average rainfall likely, there is an increased risk of widespread flooding in some parts of the east. Turning to temperature, October to December days are likely to be warmer than average across northern Australia and Tasmania, but cooler than average for southern Australia. Nights are very likely to be warmer than average across most of the country, except for southern WA. But remember, frosty nights are still possible during spring, particularly in southern WA, where there is no strong signal towards warm nights. The seasonal bushfire outlook shows mostly normal fire potential for Australia, partly thanks to the wet outlook ahead. However, spring rain can increase grass growth, which when it dries out during summer, can increase fire danger. So, in summary, October to December 2020 is likely to see above average rainfall across the eastern two-thirds of Australia, near median to low stream flows at most locations, warmer than average days in the tropics and in Tasmania, but cooler than average in the south. And frosty mornings are possible in spring, particularly in WA. Keep an eye on our forecasts. Thanks for joining us. You can find out more about the outlooks on our website. Look forward to seeing you next time.